everybody, welcome back to Project Happy Home. For those of you who are new here, welcome. I'm Tanya, doctor lawyer turned homeschooling mom of three kids ages 8, 5, and 3. I'm so happy to be continuing this collaboration with Danielle over at Danielle Gets It Done on parenting emotionally complex children. And today we're going to be talking basically about a morning routine and the importance of having a morning routine in place. In my self-care video, one of the things I had talked about as an important prong of self-care as a parent of a child who's emotionally complex or emotionally challenging is having procedures in place where the child and you have one less decision to make, where you know that this is the way morning time runs, this is the way meal time runs, this is the way getting out of the house runs. And having procedures in place is super helpful, not only because it gives you one less thing to think about, but because it lets your child, especially if that child has SPD or ADHD or ODD or anything that involves conflict and tension with choices, it eases their way because they know that whatever the next step is, it's not a punishment or a retribution or something that has no purpose. It is just the way things are done. And it's the way things are done for everybody in the house, not only them. So for my children, those routines and rules are pretty much the same for all three of them, regardless of whether they are neurotypical or a little bit more complex than others. So regardless of my son's ADHD, all the children have the same routines in place. So in today's video, we're just going to concentrate on the morning routine, and I'll just tell you how it goes in my house. It's going to be different in everyone's house. I think that this idea exists out there in the internet and on Pinterest and Instagram of the ideal morning routine. And, you know, I don't think anything is ideal for everyone. So figure out, again, what your family values are, what your own personal values are, what your children's values are, and try to make your routine reflect those and honor those values. Because if you are a family that loves to sleep in, don't try to force an early wake-up time on everybody. It's probably not the way to go to create a harmonious morning. If you're a family that really everything sort of slips and slides if you sleep in, then try to wake up a little bit earlier. So take my routine with a grain of salt. I mean, there's no reason to copy this. I'm just giving you an example of something that works for us in our household. So for a long time, I used to work full-time and all the kids had to wake up at the crack of dawn so that I could cart them either to daycare or preschool or elementary school, because my son did attend for kindergarten. And that was a whole different routine. And when I started to work part-time from home, everything shifted because suddenly I didn't have to be anywhere in the morning on most days. So with the understanding that whatever we do in our family might not work for you, I'll just let you know kind of our morning routine so that you have a framework from which to begin if you don't have anything in place. Generally, my husband wakes up really early at around 5 and leaves at around 6. I don't really want to get out of bed at 5 because it's pitch black outside and I'm just not a morning person. So I will indulge in snoozing for around half an hour, and I value that time. It's important to me. If I don't get to snooze, I really have trouble being in a good mood for the rest of the day. When I eventually do get up, I stay in bed and I have tried to incorporate the Headspace app into my morning. And sometimes I do it and sometimes I don't. I really want to get in the habit of doing it every day. The Headspace app is just a meditation app. You pay a monthly subscription fee after some free meditations that you can do. There's several other free meditation apps available. Like, I think Calm has some free meditations and Daily Om and things like that. Whatever works for you, honestly. I'm sure you can just download some from YouTube too and watch them. But I like the Headspace app because the phone is so easy and I can still curl up in bed. I put it on my stomach and I just do like a 10-minute, 15-minute meditation and try to focus on my breathing. I'm terrible at meditation, but I figure with practice, hopefully I'll get better. So at around 6 o'clock or so, I roll out of bed and I go and get ready in the bathroom. And I generally watch a YouTube video or listen to a podcast at that time. And it's a nice leisurely start to my day. I really value taking care of my skin. And so, you know, I put on several creams and things like that and serums. And it's just a nice relaxing moment where I can take care of myself. And I think that's a really important way for a mother to start her day, is to do something that takes care of herself before jumping out and taking care of kids. It's probably the biggest reason I get up before my kids do, because if I get up after my kids or if they wake me up, immediately I have to care for someone else's needs before my own. And I think psychologically that can be really damaging over time, where you start to feel a little bit like a slave in your own home to your children, who you love, who you want to take care of. This way, I'm already in the bathroom, already changed, with my face all clean, with my hair up in a ponytail, and ready to greet the day when my children wake up. If I get up by 6, generally I have enough time to also write in my journal my intentions for the day. And I use my little Hobonichi A6 that I've shown in other videos to do that. And basically, the A6 has monthly section, but it also has these daily pages. And on the daily pages, I do a pretty straightforward kind of spread where I write some intentions, and at the end of the day, I write some reflections. And it's very freeform and open-ended. Sometimes I'll use the Daily Greatness journal for parents, and I'll use some of their prompts just to like introduce some variety. I really liked how that journal started to make me think about intentionality for the day. And I'll just say sometimes I just put down words, like, I intend to be more patient and kind today. Sometimes I'll put down a specific mantra that I'll say to myself, you know, this too shall pass, let them be little, you know, above all things be kind. Something to help me set my mind and heart on a goal for the day in my interactions with my children and with my spouse and with everybody. And that's a really good way to start. And that's usually around the time when one of my children will wake up and come into the bathroom, because that's their initial thing. The girls, especially when they roll out of bed, they come to find mama. And I can give them a hug, I can hold them, I can cuddle them, I can start their day with me being excited to see them, as opposed to them waking me up and dragging me out of bed. So that's my morning routine. And then we meander back to their rooms. We, you know, I address the girls. We make their beds together. We change their clothes. Sometimes I'll try to let them change their own clothes. If you look at my girls' closet organization video, you'll see that all their clothes are in a hanging organizer, kind of like a hanging clothes rack or hanging sweater rack. And they have many different options. I don't define them by day or anything. They each generally have around 5 options, and they can choose for the day what they would like to wear. And oftentimes I can send them to go do that themselves, even the 3-year-old, and I'll say, just go pick out an outfit, get changed, and mommy will come and help you make you red. My son, on the other hand, is now at the age of 8, you know, he turned 8 last fall, finally getting used to that procedure where I no longer have to go into the room in the morning to get him started. He generally wakes up on his own at around the same time as the girls. He will make his bed on his own and he will change his clothes. He also has the same type of hanging organizer, and he just knows that that's the routine. In my house, no one gets breakfast until beds are made and your clothes are changed and your pajamas are in the hamper. Those are the 3 things you have to do. And my son has finally gotten to the point where he is really doing this on his own, you guys, and I cannot tell you what pleasure it gives me and what satisfaction and what hope for the future procedures that we're trying to like get him up to speed on. Because for a long time, every single day I had to go in, I had to wake him up, I had to say, okay, what are we gonna do now? We're gonna brush it, you know, we're gonna change our clothes now, we're going to put away our pajamas, we're gonna make our bed. And now he does all 3 of those things by himself. And so I just want to let you know that it does happen. It just happens. Particularly with ADHD, they are maturing. It's just taking a little bit longer than expected, than is typical. And so, you know, be patient, scaffold them, help them with their routine as they need it. And then one day, they will be able to do that particular routine on their own without you. And it has given me such joy to see him do that every day. And I praise him for it every single day so that he knows how proud I am of him. After that, he basically goes and, you know, if I need help with the girls, if I say like, can you help this one with their bed? He's happy to do it. And it's just made him a more cheerful person too, because for him, he likes to come out and see me first once he's already done his things, so that I can then congratulate him and be so happy and say like, you're doing such a great job making your bed now, etc. So the kids know that every morning the things they have to do is get changed, make their bed, and put their pajamas in the hamper. Then we go downstairs for breakfast. If they haven't finished those things, I've already gone downstairs and I just wait for them. When we get downstairs, I generally have a routine in place of opening up the dishwasher, and one child and one child only will help me that day, and I just rotate who it is. And they get to help unload the dishwasher. They generally put away all the kids' things, which are in a kids' cabinet, and are made out of stainless steel for the most part, so I don't worry about breaking things. And they go ahead and gather those things, they put them away. They do the silverware, they put the silverware away. And I do all the glass and breakables. But they help with the glass and breakables too, by the way. They put them on the counters below the cabinets in which those bowls or plates or cups go. And so that's their routine, and that person gets the reward of being able to put the dishwasher tablet into the dishwasher at the end. We close up the dishwasher. By then, I've pretty much gotten breakfast ready for all of them. They all sit down. And in our house, we tie TV watching, not TV, but fire watching, with meals. So I don't let the fires really travel outside of the table. And I like this rule because, one, I get to see exactly what's going on because they're all at the table. And two, I grew up in a house where most people didn't eat together. My parents were in residency when I was young and they were pretty busy. And when we grew up and my brother, who's 10 years younger than me, was around, we still watched TV together and my parents ate together and it was their time to connect. And so I sort of replicate that, where meal time is not family time for us. As a homeschooling family, we have lots of family time. So meal time is my time to either hang out by myself or hang out with my husband, and we sort of eat in the kitchen while the children eat at the table. But in the morning, they each get to watch their own show. Sometimes they decide to watch something together. Sometimes they don't. It's totally up to them. I don't really micromanage that. So long as they're watching something that is, edifying and nice, like Danielle Tiger's Neighborhood. They have another procedure when we finish up mealtime that they have to clean their areas. And that's the same words that I use every time. For routines, I really emphasize using the same words every time. So clean your area means one thing to them. That means cleaning up where they dined. And that includes someone sweeping the floor underneath for crumbs, wiping the tables. And obviously this is not perfect every day and this requires reminders and work, but they know what it means. So if I see a child off somewhere after breakfast and the table hasn't been cleaned, I will say, "Have you cleaned your area?" And they know exactly what that means and they'll hop up and go do it. They also take their water cup and put it on a coaster with their name on it on the kitchen counter so that we don't have 1,000 water cups all day, and they reuse that water cup for the rest of the day until it goes into the dishwasher. And that is our morning routine. We know that when we are about to get started with school, they'll generally have a few minutes to play or run around the house before I clean up the kitchen and everything, and then we'll get started and I'll give them a warning, school starts in 15 minutes. We don't have a set time of starting every day. Sometimes we have appointments, sometimes I have something else to do, sometimes I have something to handle for work or, just personally. And so I don't really need a set time. They'll know there's a 15 minute warning and I'll meet you guys all back at the table. We regather. Sometimes we'll start our day with some outdoor time just to shake off some of that energy. Sometimes we don't. But they know the routine. They know that, they have their responsibilities before breakfast. They have their responsibilities after breakfast. Oh, and we do brush our teeth after breakfast. So everyone knows they have to go upstairs and brush their teeth. The older ones help the younger ones. Sometimes I brush their teeth for them just to, put in a little maintenance dose in there of really good brushing. And they wipe out their sinks after they're done with brushing their teeth. I just want to build up little routines like this. In our household, we don't have set chores. We more have routines. So there's no one person responsible for cleaning up the kitchen on a given day. Everyone's responsible for cleaning up their area. Someone is responsible for unloading the dishwasher for me. Everyone's responsible for wiping out the sink after they brush their teeth. I want to incorporate chores more as routines, just regular daily things that they do immediately after another necessary activity, rather than a separate thing that requires a chart. Speaking of charts though, I do have a routine chart for my son in particular. I'm actually gonna make one for my daughter, and hopefully I'll be showing it somewhere on this screen, because my daughter just really likes charts, and my son, it just really helps. And so I generally have this chart in a cheap Dollar Tree frame, like an 8x10 frame, and he gets to cross it off with a dry erase marker as he does the tasks. And if you guys want a copy of this chart, feel free to email me at contact@projecthappyhome.com, and I will either send it to you or I'll somehow make it available in a link down below, and I'll see how to do that. And I can definitely change your name and stuff. I made it on Canva. It was really, really easy. You can make this on Canva without buying any kind of subscription or anything.
Yeah.
So that was our morning routine. I think no matter what your routine is, the most important thing is that it is something that reflects your family's values, that takes in everybody's wants and needs and personalities into consideration. I could do a lot of things differently in my morning routine, but I don't, because it doesn't suit us. Give them choices too. I think that's a really helpful tip. But I hope this was helpful, and if you guys want any copies of that schedule, or if you want to know how to make it or more about that, just leave a comment down below or send me an email at contactprojecthappyhome@gmail.com, and I'll be happy to help you out. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to check out Danielle's video. I'll link it up above and down below. I'm sure she has some great tips, because her son is a little bit younger than mine, and I think it'll be a little bit more relevant for families with kids who are about that age. So, because I have a lot of bigger helpers to help my little one. So, thank you so much for watching. As always, you guys, I wish you the very best day.